when the International Center for Biosaline Agriculture, ICBA, was established in 1999 by the Islamic Development Bank and the government of United Arab Emirates, salinization was already a major issue in many parts of the world. So ICBA was tasked to find solution to effectively manage soil and water salinity. In other ways, to find different uses for saline water for agricultural purposes.
Since then, ICBA has done a great deal to develop and introduce suitable crops and technologies to improve agriculture in salt-affected and other degraded environments. They include salt-tolerant and halophytic crops, improved land and water management practices that control salinity, improve water use efficiency, and rehabilitate degraded soils, controlled environment and integrated agri-aquaculture systems, and many others. But due to lack of concerted global action and long-term dedicated funding, among other things, salinization has been on the rise. Every day since the early 1990s, some 2,000 hectares of irrigated land in arid and semi-arid areas across 75 countries have been degraded by salt. Over the years, not only the scale, but also the range of threats to food, water, and income security of vulnerable communities around the world has increased. In response, ICBA has expanded its mandate to deal with a broader set of challenges in marginal environments where around 1.7 billion people live. Today, ICBA identifies, tests and introduces climate-smart crops and resource-efficient technologies in different regions. ICBA has been helping to improve food security and livelihoods for thousands of smallholder and marginal farmers from Africa to the Middle East to Central Asia. For example, the centre has been equipping smallholder and marginal farmers with stress-tolerant crops, such as quinoa and pearl millet, and skills to grow them so that they are better prepared for climate change-related risks. To tackle water security, ICBA has been promoting resource-efficient technologies like small-scale irrigation and the use of saline water and treated wastewater for food, feed, and biofuel production. Through climate change modelling and downscaling, ICBA has been helping decision-makers to address climate change effects on water and agriculture. Over the years, ICBA has also advised policymakers in many countries on agriculture, food, salinity, and water management strategies. A lot has been achieved since ICBA set out on its mission, but even more is yet to be done as the world population is projected to reach 8.5 billion by 2030, and future food security is threatened by climate change. As the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development defines a plan of action for people, the planet, and prosperity over the coming years, ICBA will also contribute to the achievement of Sustainable Development Goals.
As long as there are vulnerable farming communities around the world, ICBA will continue to work towards ensuring their food security, nutrition security, and improving their livelihoods.